Muna, or also pronounced Mona, says, I live in Saudi Arabia and I fear going back to my home country for vacations as my iman goes down when we visit there. No matter how pious and practicing we are here, everyone after going there for vacations become very weak in iman and get sucked into free mixing with non-mahram relatives as there's no concept of segregation there. Wearing light makeup because everyone else does this, etc. So please guide. First of all, Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah, whom we are attributed to, believe that iman increases and decreases. So your iman in your heart increases with good deeds, with hasanat, and it decreases with bad deeds, with sins. So this is normal. If I am with righteous practicing Muslims 24/7, I feel different when I travel for vacation or for a business trip outside of my comfort zone. And this is why Hanzala al-Asdi or Usdi, may Allah be pleased with him, and the hadith is Sahih Imam Muslim, stated that Nafaqa Hanzala, Hanzala has become a hypocrite. And when they went to the Prophet ﷺ with Abu Bakr, and he explained, he said, O Prophet of Allah, when we are with you, we feel different. But when we go back to our children and wives and to our businesses, we feel different. So the Prophet ﷺ said to him, if you were with your family, with your wives and children and businesses, like you are with me, meaning 24/7, the angels would descend and shake hands in broad daylight with you. But an hour and an hour to your heart, which is refreshing and charging your heart with iman, and an hour for things that you have to do, you have to earn, you have to sit with your kids and with your wives and to eat with them and to attend your businesses. So this is normal, Muna. However, what is not normal is to surrender, to give up for the pressure. And unfortunately, a lot of us seem to fall into this, falling under pressure and conceding because I can't do anything. I'm swimming against the tide, which is wrong. You, your husband, your children, as you, and this is one of the greatest blessings of Allah Azza wa Jal upon expats living in Saudi Arabia. Allah has blessed them regardless of the economical situation, regardless of any other aspect. They are blessed to be living in the lands of Islam where they hear the adhan 24/7. When they meet Muslims, greeting them with assalamu alaikum, when they feel safe for themselves, for their children, for their wives, and everything seems to be, alhamdulillah, beautiful. They learn from the scholars, they learn from the imams of the masjid, the judges are all around them, they can go for fatwas and for their problems and issues. Everywhere is circles and sessions of Quran. They can travel to Mecca, they can travel to Medina. So the boost of iman is to the fullest in their hearts. Now, once they go back to their homes, it's not going to be the same. But this is why you always ask Allah in your sujood to make you blessed wherever you are. وَجَعَلَنِي مُبَارَكًا. So you want Allah to make you blessed wherever you go. Whether you go to Europe, whether you go to India, whether you go to the Far East, ask Allah to make you blessed. And by being blessed is to have an impact wherever you go. So your husband has to draw the red line, has to tell his family, listen, I'm a Muslim, I practice Islam, and Islam fights and prohibits free mixing. So there has to be from now on segregation. Your father, your mother, would not like this. And they will say, no, we will not segregate. No problem. You've done your duty. Segregate. Don't go to their free mixing parties or gatherings. Don't mix with your cousins, with your sisters-in-laws, etc., or brothers-in-law, depending on your gender. But stay and remain steadfast. Because this is what the Prophet ﷺ would have done. And this is how us Muslims should stick together. Now, secondly, once you go there for vacations or you go there for final exit, you have to make an environment that is similar to what was here in the Muslim world, in the sense that you have to surround yourself with righteous practicing Muslims so that your children would still meet Muslim children, so that you would be in an environment. It's very wrong for you as a Muslim to go and live among the kuffar. So if your country is a non-Muslim country, select a neighborhood, a city, a town where the majority would be Muslims. This way, no one can lynch you. No one can attack you, abuse you as a minority when you're living among the kafir. No, you guys have to come closer, protect one another so that you can feel safer. And at the same time, the Islamic environment is there. And finally, make a lot of dua in your sujood, so that Allah would make you steadfast with your family, and that Allah gives you the knowledge and courage to give da'wah, to call people to Islam and to show them the right way.